Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, please subscribe and turn on notifications so you can get notified every time I post a new video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make basic white slime. The ingredients you'll need is glue. You can use clear glue or white glue. I'm using white glue. And your activator. I'm using borax activator and it's 2 cups of warm water to 1 teaspoon of borax powder. And the utensils will be a spoon or a spatula or any mixing tool and a bowl. So let's pour your glue in. There's dry glue in this layer, which is so annoying. You can put as much as you want. It's up to you. I'm making a lot of slime. So basically almost like done, because you just need to add your activator. Add it little by little and stir it, because if you add too much at a time, you might overactivate it by accident. Oh my god, that's a lot. But I find that my borax mixtures it looks like it's activating, but it's actually not, which is really weird, but yeah. Also, it's really important that you use warm water, because then the borax won't dilute properly if you do cold water. You can do hot water as well if you want, but you'll have to wait for it to cool down a bit. And just mix and stir, don't forget to do it little by little, because you don't want to overactivate it. And some glues will activate really quickly, but some might not. I'm using the washable school glue, but some people use the clear school glue or what's it called again? Glue all. The glue all one needs lots of activator. And if it looks like it's starting to activate, it should pull away from the bowl when it's time for you to knead with your hands. As you can see, mine's not pulling away yet because it needs lots of activator, because I'm basically making a lot of slime. It's sticking to the spoon like crazy, and I got it on my finger. It's kind of starting to pull away from the bowl. And also, I recommend using a spatula if you're making a big slime, because using a small spoon is really hard to mix. Some people use chopsticks, and you can do that too, but the glue just might stick to the chopsticks and you might not be able to get it off, so think about that before you use chopsticks. And it's all gluey, and just keep on stirring. If it looks like it's too much activator, keep stirring, and then it will start to pull away from the bowls. batch of slime, then you can like add like lots of activator at a time. But just be careful not to add too much at a time because you don't want to overactivate it. It's starting to pull away from the ball, which is what we want. My arm hurts. This is a workout. Also, if you're under the age of 18, get parental supervision because you don't want to hurt yourself when you're making the borax mixture, because borax can burn your hand really badly. This is a real workout, not lying. I don't have any more strength. Well, it's really actually starting to pull away from the ball. It's really starting to pull away from the ball now. Oh, that sound, that's so weird. It's starting to not really stick to the spoon anymore, as you can see here. I can kind of clean it. Clean up the spoon a little bit now, which is really cool, and it's also a sign that your slime is starting to form. Oh, I have a little bit of slime on my finger. I'm gonna put it in there now. Can go in with your hands, but first put a little bit of activator on your fingers so it doesn't really stick, because you don't want it to get all messy, because your mom and dad will get really angry at you if you get it all messy. Necessary, add a little bit of more activator if you really need to. If it's okay, like this, oopsies, you can still add a little bit of activator, just a little bit, because if you add too much, it will overactivate the slime. Starting to not stick to the ball anymore, which together, not on the bowl. If it really does stick to you, place your hand into your academia, or if you're using contact lens solution or Tide, or any of the other ones, like you want to add a little bit more, but not too much. If it's pulling away from the ball but still looks really watery, do the finger test. But it's when you poke your finger in, and if you can get it off cleanly without leaving any bits, then it means it's okay to start eating. But you want to be careful not to get it on your clothes, because your mom and dad will be really angry. Wear an apron if necessary. Want to add food coloring or any type of paint to color your slime, you can do that, but I'm not because this is a basic slime. Basic slimes sometimes don't even have coloring in it, but it's up to you. You can add it if you want. Now it's starting to form. When it only sticks to when it starts sticking to the slime, when the slime starts sticking to each other and not the bowl anymore, you can stop. You can pour it out and put it on the table. But make sure you have like a mat to protect it. Otherwise you might get the table all glowy, which you don't want. You want it to be really nice. As you can see here, it is starting to form. And now I'm going to get my sleeves up and I'm going to pour it on the table. But you don't want it to drip out, so make sure you give your slime lots of space for it to, you know, spread. Bubbles and then crunch it, and it's also really satisfying. And the cap is under the chair. I'm washing my hands with the activators. You can make more because sometimes the glue doesn't look like it's a lot when you, sometimes the glue looks like it's a lot when you pour it, but then otherwise it will dry out. So I'm using, let me get it. I'm using this container. Oh my god, the lid's going everywhere. Oh, that's the cat eating. So I'm using this container, and it's an airtight container. You can add more activator if you want, but if you don't want to, then you don't have to. You can leave it a bit sticky, but if you don't want to, again, you don't have to. It's your time, you make your choices. So mine was still a little bit sticky, so I added a little bit more activator. And if the sign rips, it's okay because you haven't finished kneading the activator yet. And if it feels like it's still sticky but it rips after you finish kneading it, start in your container, and then the next day open it and it will be better and it won't stick to you much anymore. So yeah, that's it. See you next time. Bye.